Okay, so I'm just going to use what we've done in the other tutorials and draw the front view of this bearing journal. So I'm going to start with a line, and we'll just do the outside bounding box of this part, 6 inches long, and it's up 2.5 inches. Back over 6, enter, and just type C, enter, and that will close that box off. Move this over a little bit. Okay, so now maybe we'll be able to see everything. And up here at the top, I want to put this arch in here, so I'm going to start with a circle, and the radius is 1. Notice that when you do a circle command, he's asking for a radius, or you can hit D for diameter, but I want to put in a radius of 1. Now I'm going to use the trim command and select the cutting edges, and then touch what I want to get rid of, namely those parts. Now I've got these two holes on the sides. Need to find a location for them. I can see that they're 4.75 center to center, and that would be this big. So I'm going to lay those out with a circle, and then I'm going to copy this line from that base point to that intersection, and then I'm going to offset. They are 0.5 off of the top, like that, and I'll put my circle here. Now I want to give it a diameter, because it's a half inch diameter, so I'll type D, enter. Now he wants a diameter of 0.5. There's my circle. Now I'll erase my construction lines. I'll come in here and I'll just draw a circle to use to trim off what will become my center lines. And now the other side is exactly the same, so I'll mirror, MI for mirror, select the objects, hit enter when I'm done selecting. I'm going to mirror about this midpoint. Notice I need to turn ortho on. You can hit F8 for ortho if you'd rather do that. And then it disappears. And notice he's asking you whether or not you want him to delete the source objects. The answer is no, so just hit enter. Now we need to do this shape down here at the bottom. I'll do that with offsetting. I'm going to offset 0.75. That gets me this dimension here to the inside. And then notice that we've got 4 inches in the middle there. So I'm going to use a circle again, diameter of 4. And I'll copy this nice vertical line. I can erase this now, trim this off. That's half of it. And now I'll mirror this part of it. And again, trim. And let's see, that gives me the inside of this C shape. It also goes all the way through, so I can trim that off. Now I need to do a little bit of offsetting. Well, let's see. No, we don't want to offset. We want to offset 0.375. If I didn't know it was 0.375, I could do the math. AutoCAD's got its own calculator in there, so I can just say apostrophe cal while my command's going. That's a transparent command, and I've got a calculator now, and I can say, well, what is 4.75 minus 4? Hopefully that's okay. Oh, it's 0.75. Well, what's half of that? Let's cal again, and 0.75 divided by 2. Hopefully we'll get 3/8. There we go, 0.375, and I can actually, it has entered that as the offset distance. Okay, because I said I want to offset, and he said, well, how much do you want to offset? And I said, well, let me calculate it. And so I hit cal, and the evaluation of that expression winds up being 0.375, so that's the way to do it. So I'm offsetting. Well, I never told him yes, so offset that. All around, we've got a fillet on here, 0.125. Radius 0.125, enter, select that and that, select that and that, and now all we lack is this 3-inch wide part down the middle. So I can just draw a line, let's say from there, offset it half of 3, and it goes all the way up. I just need to trim this off. Okay, I think that's it. Did I miss anything? That's all.